Hello guys, this is Matty Ace. I'm coming at you here with my first weapon review in a long time, and it's the NS-11C that, being that it is NS, it can be used by all the three empires. Now, lately I have almost exclusively played Light Assault, but you can of course use this weapon as engineer as well, which is the class that I used to play a lot in the past, but yeah, lately I've really enjoyed the mobility of the Light Assault class. So now the first clip here is from the very beginning of when I started using this weapon. I started with the night vision scope, and I also had the high velocity ammo here, combined with the compensator and the forward grip. And during this video what you'll see is that I'm changing the scopes a bit. I'm also using the one-time reflex sight, and I'm also trying out the iron sight. Now the iron sight is pretty good in this weapon. The problem is that towards some backgrounds it is a little bit hard to really determine where your enemies actually are. So yeah, I don't really recommend iron sights all that much in planet sight, unfortunately, but you'll see me using it quite a bit here, and I'll let you know a little bit of why I choose the scopes that I choose. So here is daytime, it's Amerish. And here you see how the iron sight actually works pretty well. The problem with the iron sight in this situation is that the color of it is entirely black. And there are so many dark areas and dark backgrounds that sometimes the iron sight just blends in with it and you can't really distinguish exactly where you're aiming. Of course it varies depending on your graphic settings as well. Now, I gotta say though, I do like the shape of the iron sight on this particular weapon. I really do wish that you could to some degree customize the scopes and the iron sights in Planet Sight 2, especially when it comes to like the sight of the actual red dot in a red dot scope and the size of the actual tick of an iron sight, stuff like that, and also of course the colors. Now the next thing I want to bring up here is of course the ammunition type. Aside from the default ammo, you can choose high velocity ammo and soft point ammo. So there, altogether there's three different types. And switching from the default to any of the other two, you might not feel all that much of a difference. But once you start switching between the soft point and the high velocity ammo, you're gonna notice a massive difference, or at least I do. Now starting with the muzzle velocity, the NS-11C has only 450 meters per second bullet velocity. And this is rather slow. Now just to compare, I'd like to mention that the Trek 5, which is the default carbine of the TR, has a bullet velocity of 490 meters per second, which is the slowest of the default ones. The Mercenary of NC has 500, and the Solstice of the Vanu has 515. And these things are worth keeping in mind if you are switching to the NS-11C from the default carbine of your empire. Another quite significant change if you are replacing the default gun with this weapon is that you have the .75 aim down sight modifier, meaning that instead of strafing at half the speed while aiming down sight compared to when you're hip firing, you will with the NS-11C be moving at 3/4 of that speed. And this is one of the things that make some of these carbines very popular. And I think you have this with all NS weapons, I'm not entirely sure, but it's also very common among close range weapons in general. As you can see, I'm also using the night vision scope here, and I'm really having a hard time deciding what scope I actually do prefer. Now the night vision scope has two drawbacks that affects me quite heavily, and it's range, and it's also the scope in time. You do scope in a little bit slower with this one than with the iron sight or some of the other scopes, or all the other scopes possibly. Aside from that, you also have a little bit of scope sway with this night vision scope, but it doesn't affect me all that much. It doesn't bother me, but at ranges like this the scope sway might actually affect quite a number of players, and I've come to realize that there's a lot of players who don't even shoot at ranges like this, which makes perfect sense if you're choosing the NS-11C, especially if you don't have the long range setup for it. But even with the same attachments that I'm using here, this weapon doesn't even come close to my favorite carbine, which is the Pulsar C. But even the Racer and the T5 AMC are better choices for these type of ranges than the NS-11C, but the muzzle velocity is only part of that.
Oh, behind!
Get wrecked.
Why I always get shot behind?
Yeah, Sky General is gonna revive you. And now he's gone.
Yeah, also, don't want to kill the Sandy.
If I can get to you, I will. I can chuck a res grenade up.
Do it.
Over here! You can get through here.
And yeah, going back to the choice of scopes again, I'm using the iron sight here on Esamir, and it comes most natural being that Esamir has a lot of a white background. It's the snowy continent, but as a matter of fact, the rocky parts of this environment is actually rather dark, and again, the tick of the iron sight has a tendency to blend in with that. Now, even though I do shoot a lot at mid-range, I've actually decided to replace the high-velocity ammo with soft-point ammo, and that's because I think that the soft-point ammo is more of a benefit at close range than high-velocity is at mid-range. You will see in the later part of the video how I'm using the soft-point ammo and how it also makes me struggle a lot more at ranges. Like, it's actually quite a big difference, and I'll try to get some more close-quarter combat with it, and hopefully I'll be able to upload that as well. Now, this carbine has been given a lot of credit for being versatile, but I think that the versatility of this weapon is quite overestimated. I would mostly recommend this weapon to close range players that are willing to trade some of their CQC advantages in order to be better at ranges past 25 meters. And the fact is, comparing this weapon with a close range carbine, the NS11C really falls behind, especially when it comes to fire rate. As with the NS11C, you will be stuck at 652 rounds per minute. And comparing this to the 845 rounds per minute with the GD7F, for example, you'll see the problem right there. The same goes for all close-range carbines that I've tried, and the fact is that these specialized weapons, whether it's mid-range or close-range, are, in my opinion, quite a lot better than the NS11C at their specific rules. However, I do sometimes feel that some of the mid-range carbines actually are more versatile than they are given credit for, and the same goes for close-range weapons. Now, one of the things that I do think makes it quite popular, though, is that it's very easy to control. The recoil pattern and the spread pattern, it doesn't take much time to get used to it, and once you get used to it, you see that there's not much to talk about, even with the increased recoil of high-velocity ammo. And what is normally much more problematic, the spread left and right, this weapon doesn't have all that much of it either. Or at least it's quite easy to control. And there's fucking PPA spam everywhere.
What does that mech fighter even doing here?
Yeah, we should kill it. You know what? I'll go. I'll spawn rocket pods. Spawn rocket pods. Redeploy. Redeploy.
Yeah.
Rocket pods.
Fucking kidding me.
Generator stabilized.
So from this moment on in the video, I will be using the soft point ammo. I'm not entirely sure exactly where I did switch, so you might have already seen it, and I do apologize that I can't be more specific. Now, being that this weapon is more suited for close and closer mid-range engagements, or at least that's my opinion about it, you might actually want to try out the advanced laser sight for it. It hipfires pretty well, as you may or may not have seen in this video already, but again, with the forward grip and the compensator, you're gonna lose quite a lot of your hipfire capabilities.
Black armor, I would have died 3 times already. They keep capping C point.
Yeah, the flanking. That's what good players do, they flank.
Flanking nothing. Roll out number.
Do you like the NS11C?
Not really, yet. I guess it doesn't fit my playstyle, but no, I don't really like it. Or maybe... I don't know. I can't put my finger on it, there's something about this weapon that I don't really like.
Oh, Schwarzbrot.
What about him? So I'm a little bit indecisive of what I think about this weapon, to be perfectly honest. Some of my friends in the Outfit Fool has used it quite a bit. One of them, Gille, well, he's not really my friend, to be perfectly honest. I'm just using him to get some proton PPI kills. But yeah, don't tell him that, please. Now, the thing is that if you buy this weapon for station cash, you will of course have it for all your characters. It is an NS weapon after all, and that is one of the big benefits of it. And of course the 0.75 movement modifier. And here I'll just quickly show you the problem with switching from high velocity ammo to the soft point ammo. And had I been using the pulse there, for example, that would have been an easy kill. But I didn't adjust my aim for the weapon at hand. So yeah, try to keep that in mind. And check out the differences this weapon has compared to the weapon you had before, if you decided to get this weapon. So yeah, that's basically it. I hope you enjoyed the review. I know it was a little bit premature. I have about 700 kills with this weapon at the release of this video. But yeah, it seems to be the ongoing trend in Planet Side 2 to make a weapon review even before you get your first 1,000 kills. So I'm just trying to go with the flow here, and I hope you appreciate it. Yeah, there's quite a bit more gameplay in this video, and I hope you will enjoy it. But for the review and the post commenting, I am done. So thank you all for watching. Bye for now.
Yeah, we can't go for the outside places because of the PPA spam, right?
Yeah. And the galaxy.
Yeah, okay.
I'm trying to tank post them.
One of them.
Oh, are you? Well, we could go with you. I could go with you.
Holy shit, they are out repairing my tank buster. What the fuck?
Really? They out repair your tank buster?
Yeah.
What?
Galaxy must be full or something.
Yeah.
But that's balanced, and you know that?
Galaxies are supposed to be the fucking weakest air vehicle in the game. It should be, it's supposed to be a transport vehicle.
Yeah.
But it is now, it's the strongest vehicle, air vehicle in the game.
Yeah,
I switched to AA, but I think that's not gonna do much.
Oh, that.
I spent to the fucking galaxy.
Don't forget that we are fighting. Yeah.
Jump
farther,
go.
Oh, yeah,
and I got team killed by a man.
By what?
Not your day.
No, not my day. Then I got a wrench in Los and see if I can kill some people.
Sometimes it's like the flag is not consistent. And no, the reavers are also, you know.
Yeah.
Not key reavers.
I see them. Oh, yeah. As soon as I hit the... Yeah, I get a round locker. Still weapons.
Yeah, that's something that's there a lot. You can pretty much stay until you have to pop flash, which is almost...